They still call marijuana a gateway drug, even though it's already been proven that that is not the case. We are Kurly and Kansai, and we're talking to you. Hey, this is Kurly and Kansai,
a podcast about us two curly-headed ladies living in the Kansai area of
Japan.
And welcome back to another episode.
It's been a minute.
Yes. Usually I say my name.
Oh, yeah.
But it has been a minute. Whatever. For those who forgot, my name is Ayana.
I'm Alyse.
And this is episode, is that right?
I don't know.
58.
You know I don't know. I don't count
Yeah,
numbers.
We don't really count. I just like to count, but, you know.
Yeah. So why has it been so long, though?
So we're on live stream right now on Facebook and Instagram, even though they're the same company. I was out of the country.
Yes.
We didn't do an episode.
Yes.
That's it, just one, right?
I don't know.
Because we did one right before I left.
Yes.
So it was just one that we didn't do. Yeah. Because, like, we're technically supposed to be doing, like...
Twice a month.
But, you know, things happen.
Life happens.
Life always happens. And this year, it was really hard to do twice a month.
It was a struggle.
It was a big struggle, so... If you are watching on our live, please comment.
Feel free
to comment, interject anytime. We are doing something different. So first, we'll talk about our last episode. So last episode, we talked about... Oh my God. What did we talk about? I forgot.
Let me check on my phone.
Oh, I remember. Okay. It was Weird Flex Japan. So it was all... Yeah, that was the title. So we were talking about like all the weird things... Not the weird things. What was it? The person commented on Twitter saying that I had a weird flex because I was complaining about not wanting to speak to someone in the elevator, but I was like reading my mail, which is in Japanese. Mm-hmm. So they said that was a weird flex. So technically, it wasn't a flex, but we were talking mostly about like, what were we talking about?
Let's see.
I kind of forgot. Yo, it's been a while, like we said. Is this episode 58?
What is time? Are we even in this moment right now?
Hi, y'all. Don't worry about the number of this episode. This episode, we'll talk about mainly drugs.
And we're supposed to talk about the last comment from the
episode. Let's just go on about the last comment. So the last episode, we're going to take a comment from our friend Marissa. She was on the episode. She was on, which episode was it?
This is the Afro-Latina episode?
Oh, yeah. She was on the show for the Afro-Latino episode. And she said, please read because I can't.
Oh. So it was in relation to a tweet I made. Because I was translating the weird anti-feminist tweets that you find on Japanese Twitter. And one of the Japanese tweets that I translated said that there hasn't been an update to what feminists believe in the past 30 years, is what the Japanese person was saying. So her comment was, maybe because y'all still hate women and treat them like shit. She said that, not me. I don't know. Maybe it has to do with the fact that even though women have been campaigning for equal treatment as humans for over a century, they're still considered property in many countries. Thousands, millions continue to live a life in which they remain uneducated, unemployed, raped, assaulted, murdered, and otherwise debased. Why hasn't feminist ideology changed over the decades? You must be stupid, huh? It's because society hasn't changed how they treat women. Duh.
Yes.
So.
Yeah.
She's also living, working, surviving in Japan. So we feel that.
We feel the same, indeed. Yeah. So because I'm all out of whack, I thought I was organized. I can't really comment more about the last episode.
I do remember mentioning, I think, those Japanese, the weird Japanese anti-feminist tweets.
Oh, yeah. You're right. That was it. But still.
And some other stuff.
My brain is still putty. I still have jet lag.
We've moved on to the Christmas spirit now.
Yeah. So even though drugs.
Oh, yeah, but yeah, that has nothing to do with the Christmas spirit.
Okay, well.
It's fine.
I don't know if it's going to be that, like,
So, you might be wondering why we decided to talk about drugs. They're very illegal in Japan, as you all know, but the reason that we've decided to make this a topic today is because there's been an uptick in the number of drug-related news stories in Japan especially in the last year, there has been like wide, I don't want to say widespread, but there has been, yeah, there's been widespread coverage, mostly of celebrities that have been caught with drugs. So they're either getting in trouble for like a drug possession or drug use, because they will test your urine and see if you've been using drugs, and then they will get you, they will charge you for use if you don't have it on you. And it's been, I think there's been something like 6 or 7 cases just this year alone that I can, that I at least remember reading on the article you sent earlier. And a lot of people think that it's because of the Olympics, they're coming up. So they're, the police are really trying to crack down on that kind of illicit behavior, because the common fear of the Japanese police is that if the foreigners start doing it, they will be powerless to stop them.
Right. I don't know what you said. I'm joking.
So that's why we decided to talk about
Yeah, that is today. Exactly why. And also, I felt it was interesting because, like, I just came back from the States. I was in L.A. for the last part of my trip. Mm-hmm. And, you know, L.A., they have legal... recreational legal marijuana. And it's like, okay, I took some edibles. It was nice. But, like, I bought a pack. And I'm like, I can't bring this back because it's illegal in Japan.
Right.
And, you know, some people, like my cousin, like, oh, just bring it back. Just put it in your suitcase. They won't even know the difference. I'm like, I'm don't not risking it. I read an article even before I came to, before I went to the States, I read the article about this girl who got arrested recently. And I'm just like, even though it was via post, I don't want to risk that.
Right.
So, yeah. Shout out to LA.
LA doing big things.
So, yeah, it was fun to do, you know, the recreational things, but, you know.
In Japan, you only have recreational alcohol.
Right. That's the thing. So, let's start with, I guess.
Can you talk about that article? Because I didn't read that one.
Why Japan is so strict about drugs. Yes. So, I looked at this article on kotaku.com, and it started off with a story about Pierre Taki. Do you know who that is?
Who?
Yeah, it's like, it's a celebrity.
Okay.
So, let's see. There was a story about them getting caught, arrested. And what I thought was interesting about, like, celebrities in Japan getting caught is that once they get caught, Japan is like, all right, let's just strip them from everything. They can't, like, if they're an artist, like, all their music is, like, down. If they're an actor, like, you just take them out. Yeah. If they're a voice actor, it's like, all right, take them out of that. And I'm just like, what
they're kind
in
of
the
erased
world?
From the public mind.
It's just ridiculous. Yeah. And it's just, like, and it's sudden, too.
It's very quick.
It's very, very quick. So let's see. What is this one, this quote I had?
There is a Vice documentary about the history of marijuana in Japan, because it was legal until the end of World War II, I believe they said. And they used to have a big hemp industry.
And from what I read, it said it was actually banned a little bit before World War II. Then it was back to being legal. Mm-hmm. And then after the defeat, they banned it again because of the influence of the Americans.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah, so I just wanted to add that it was banned a little bit before World War II, then it was okay, then it was banned again.
Why was it banned before?
I don't remember.
Where did you see that?
I'll have to look that up again. But that's what I read. Mm-hmm. So just to kind of like give some new word in Japanese.
Uh-oh. Japanese language class.
So about that, what I just said before about like taking everything down if they get caught. So this isn't mere ostracization or punishment. All these examples of what it's called jishuku in Japanese, which means self-restraint. This is not unique to Japan. Japan, it says. People all over the world feel self-restraint, blah, blah, blah. But in Japan, companies and media conglomerates feel it acutely and quickly. What? I don't know.
Yeah, they feel it.
Like they feel it. Right, they have to do it. Okay. They are not required to take actions like taking all this artist the stuff down, but they do so because they're expected to. So, what is that? Okay. So the word basically jishuku is what it describes like when companies take down like their artists or
actors. They willingly take down, these advertisements or...
And like, what I read more about in that article is that, like, even though they know it's a hassle, they feel like they have to do it. So they always, like, profusely say, sorry. Like, we know that it's, like, troublesome to, like, change everything. Mm-hmm. But they got caught with drugs, so it's like, can't have them there.
Shoganaina.
But some of the artists or actors, they do come back, but it's usually after like 10 years or so.
It takes, well, not always 10 years, but it does take a few years. It's not going to be like 6 months and then you can come back.
No.
For sure. It's not going to be that quickly.
So on the Facebook Live, Jan Jan says, "You're not afraid of medical check time? You eating edibles? Like, who's going to check me? I'm not working in, I'm not working in a full-time company and they don't really do urine checks like that."
They do check your urine at the yearly medical check.
Yeah, but
I'm not... I don't know what they'd be testing for.
I'm not going to have one anytime soon.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
I'm not a full-time person. Mika says, "Hi, guys. There's a marijuana museum in Tokyo."
Oh, how about that?
I did not know that. What was it? Japan decided its rules on cannabis after we were defeated in the end of World War II and the Americans came here. Junichi Takayasu said, the curator of the marijuana museum in Tochigi Prefecture. So Tokyo and Tochigi, is that the same or different? Maybe, I don't know. Japan actually had a small but long-standing use of hemp, which was used for cloth, paper, and traditional medicine. That I knew. But that changed in 1945 because the Americans brought with them the concept of full prohibition, just as they had done with alcohol in the 1920s and the early 1930s. And I see no likelihood of the government here relaxing its rules anytime soon. So if you see him in the doc, Alyse, I put, "Gah, but alcohol is not banned still, gah!" Yeah. So, like, the prohibition came and I guess Japan banned alcohol, but then...
What? No, they didn't ban. They banned marijuana.
Only marijuana?
Yes, they got prohibition from the U.S., but they only banned marijuana.
Okay, so when I read it, I thought they also banned alcohol, too.
No. They were just saying that they got the idea of prohibition from the Americans, and they instituted it for marijuana because...
Okay, I get it now.
You know, I guess it's fun to shit on everyone's party.
Mm-hmm. I guess so.
Yeah, they said they talk about the same thing in the Vice documentary.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Maybe they mentioned that museum too, but I watched it years ago.
I don't remember that. I didn't watch it. I actually should watch it. Send me the link.
Vice has some good documentaries on Japanese things.
Mm-hmm.
Will do.
All right, so then the next thing that I saw, I mentioned a little bit about a girl being arrested recently, actually. Mm-hmm. Basically, what happened is this Norwegian autistic girl who's, you know, doing good things in Japan, got arrested in November before a package she got, or she didn't actually receive it herself, in April. Mm-hmm. And what happened was she was... I guess her friend in the States makes cookies, and she ordered these decorative cookies to come to her in Japan. And her friend did not tell her that she put THC in the cookies.
Hmm.
She didn't tell them that. So when she sent the cookies to this address that wasn't even her home because she was house sitting somewhere, it got stopped in the post, and they found out it was, you know, there was marijuana in it. But they didn't arrest her until November. I don't know why. Like, I still don't understand why they didn't arrest her.
When did they stop the post?
In April.
Oh, wow. That's not really long. Maybe they were trying to get some kind of warrant or something?
I don't know.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I mean, that's really long.
I don't know either. So, then, like, you know, she didn't know about it. And she, you know, kept saying she didn't know about it. But they still, like, detained her for almost maximum time. And, you know, when it happened, like, during the time it happened, I had seen, like, what do you call it? It's signing. You signing. When you sign a paper, so they stop what happens. What is it called?
Cease and desist?
No. What? Like, people going around on the internet, like, sign this and help her.
A petition?
Thank you! That's the word. So a petition was going around and trying to help her. They had, like, the whole story, like, you know, bullet, all the stuff that happened. And I was like, oh, crap. And this was before I went to the States.
Mm.
So I read that. I'm like, wow, well, I hope I can try to help her out. I don't actually, it was it a petition or was it just like knowledge? Like, please know what's going on and help her out.
I haven't heard. This is my first time hearing about it. Was when Kiki shared it.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know why I find
it wasn't on the Japanese news.
Yeah, no, it wouldn't be. They wouldn't put it on the Japanese news. So, yeah, I saw that. And then when I came back is when I saw the update and she got out. But basically, she was forced to be in solitary confinement. And she got, like...
Han got strip searched at the, at the airport.
Oh, okay. So our friend Han said, also, fun fact, I got strip searched at customs because they thought I had drugs. I'm pretty sure they thought they took... Oh, I'm pretty sure they took me in the back room. Well, that's because you look like a druggie.
Sus.
I'm joking.
That's so mean. You're terrible.
Well, he's from LA. Maybe they'll.
Maybe they might stop people from LA more.
That's what I'm thinking.
I've never been stopped, but I don't fly out from any place with a known drug usage.
I mean, like, I went to the airport and my cousin said, oh, I've flown with marijuana before or like candies or edibles before. Mm-hmm. But that was domestic.
Mm, right.
So when you go into the international section, there's dogs that sniff everybody's stuff, like right before you go down to the next station to like check in or whatever. Mm. So there's that.
It's a little extra layers of
stuff. They're trying to help us out because they're like, you know, you're going to a different country that probably doesn't allow marijuana. So we're trying to help you by sniffing your bags and telling you no. All right. Clinton, oh, thank you. Nice to see your beautiful faces and smiles, he said. Thank you. What is this? Jan, it was sent to two girls. Oh, okay. So clarifying the story with the Norwegian girl. One girl went back to Europe before entering Japan again, and they nabbed her first at the airport. Ooh. So they could have possibly caused the long delay. She was arrested after that. Seymour. after they released the friend.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. So they they released the friend that the house of the friend
that went to. Yeah, the friend the house, the owner of the house or the renter of that house.
Sent to. Yeah, they that got was her sent first, to. Right. And then she was like, I don't know what y'all talking about. And then they went after the other girl. Is what I remember reading.
Oh, okay. So that's what happened. That's why it delayed. Maybe. And got arrested in November. So basically, nobody send me ish. Nothing. I don't send me cough syrup.
But they still be having like little marijuana t-shirts and socks in Japan. So it's like, what do you really want?
That's just, you know, what do you call it? Merch. That's just merch. That's not actual.
They still got head shops though. So.
I don't know what to tell you.
They kind of don't like it, but they kind of do.
They think it's cool. Like marijuana is cool, but it's illegal. So we can't do it. All right, moving forward.
I guess people got to make money. Get money.
This is true. So there was another incident with a foreigner.
Yes.
Which you just read. Can you explain it? The Adderall.
Mm-hmm. So in this case, it was something that was actually a medication, a type of medication. The problem is that this medication is banned in Japan. It's Adderall. Mm-hmm. So it is an amphetamine, yes. I believe. And yes, amphetamines in any form are illegal in Japan. Yes. So this woman was getting, she sent her luggage from South Korea to Japan because she was moving to Japan to become a teacher. And inside of her belongings, I guess she had her medication, her Adderall, but it was not in the prescription bottle, which I had always heard you should keep, especially if you're going overseas, you should keep your medication in the prescription bottle because then they will think you're smuggling it.
Right.
So, like, anytime that I had to bring, like, my allergy meds, which has, like, some allergy meds that are legal in the U.S. are illegal here.
Yeah.
So, if I bring allergy meds, I keep it in the allergy meds bottle. So, it's like, look, this is
real, legit allergy prescription. Medicine.
And I've never been arrested so far. So far, so good.
So far. So good.
But, yeah, so she didn't have her medication in the prescription bottle. She had it in a bottle of Tylenol, and the police found it, and they basically was like, You're smuggling in amphetamines. And they arrested her. And she was in prison. She was, like, full-on in prison. A women's detention facility in Nagoya, I think it was.
Yeah.
I forget exactly where.
Yeah.
For maybe, like, 2 or 3 months.
Months?
months. Yeah, she said a few weeks. It was like
I think it was weeks. Like, yeah,
maybe it was just a few weeks. Yeah, I don't know. Not like I said before at the beginning of this episode, I'm not good with numbers. Don't even.
Okay.
So she was in the detention facility, and basically she had to get like her senator and like the ambassador to Japan to get her out, because the police were not trying to hear it. They were like,
they wanted to keep
you're a smuggler,
please say you did it, is basically what the police
say. That's one of the police's confession tactics. Like, they will isolate you, and then basically they will keep asking you. They won't even keep asking you. They'll just keep accusing you of doing something. They're like, you did it, right? Right? You did it. And because they're trying to get you to confess, because if they can get a confession, that means they can convict you for whatever crime you've done.
Right, because they only care about convictions. They don't care about actual justice.
So, yeah, she didn't confess, but I can imagine she was very stressed out. But she did eventually get released. And what I read at the end of the second article that talked about her being released, she was not in Japan anymore after that. She went back to the States, and as far as I can tell, she did not come back. If anybody has any updates on that, feel free to share. But, yeah, she said she had no hard feelings about being in prison, and she said the prison facility was very nice. So, that, I mean, at least,
I mean, because she went to a special one, I think. Some people just, I don't know, like, when I read it, it looked like it was for ladies, like.
Well, yeah, women and men.
Yeah, I don't know why I said that. I don't know, it just looked like, it was like a nice name. I'm like, maybe it's a special facility.
They called it a detention facility. Oh, okay. They didn't call it a prison. It wasn't like a federal max.
Yeah, not like where murderers usually go, I guess.
Yeah, I'm not super familiar with the Japanese prison complex, so I don't quite know how it breaks down. But from what I've seen on TV, they're fairly just very quiet. People, they just do chores, and everyone's just, they just spend time alone by themselves. And it's like the one guy that escaped from prison, a prison that's on an island, because it had no walls. It's a wall. It's a prison in Japan have walls, okay, but it's on an island.
Okay.
And they kind of just expect prisoners not to run away because it's a kind of laxed kind of prison. Like, I guess it's an enjoyable prison, so they don't expect their prisoners to want to run away. But this one guy did, and that became a big problem in Japan because they were like, why did he run away? And they were like, oh, no, I guess he didn't like it. I don't like it. There was no real...
Interesting.
That's Japan, though. But now... they have sensors on the windows, so the prisoners cannot escape. And cameras. But still no walls.
Okay. Well, then. But is it far from mainland?
No, he swam across. It's in one of the small islands between, like, Hiroshima and Shikoku, I think.
Okay.
So he swam back to, like, Shikoku or Hiroshima. I forget which
Interesting.
One.
Interesting. Well, then. I don't know. But I hear, like, a lot of different experiences from people saying, like, when they're detained, it's really harsh for them. Probably if they're in, like, a isolated, what, confinement? Is that the word?
Solitary
confinement. Same thing. they're fine, but, like, when they're talking to the prosecutor, that's when they have a lot of issues where it's, like, they're tied to the chair, they make it tight.
Oh.
Like, that's what happened to the Norwegian girl, because she said that it felt very, like, tight on her.
Oh, yeah, she didn't mention that. Yeah, they were not being very kind.
No, not at all.
So.
They were really trying to force.
Anyway, we're talking about Japanese prison complex. We're supposed to be talking about drugs.
That's true, sorry. But it's still connected, because they arrest them.
Yeah. So, also in Japan... speaking of amphetamines,
yes,
since that was what the girl got arrested for, they're particularly, according to that article, they are rather strict when it comes to amphetamines.
Mm-hmm.
And it is because that historically Japan has used amphetamines in a military and professional way.
Yes.
So during the war it was used. After the war it was also used. According to that article, it was used to help stifle hunger.
Oh.
And to help people work long hours. So a lot of jobs gave it to people so they could do all that overtime. And according to the documentary that was also linked in that article, which I have seen, it's an old documentary from like 1996. But a lot of, in the 90s, during like right at the, more or less at the end of the bubble era.
Mm-hmm.
But when people were doing those world-renowned long hours of overtime, a lot of people were using amphetamines to do this, and as a result they became addicted, which is why there are a large number of abusers of amphetamines, and especially according to the police TV shows that are on TV. What is it? The white stuff you inject in your arm.
Heroin?
Is that heroin? They call it Kokusei.
Oh, I would assume that's heroin.
It's not brown, though. Oh, that's just black tar heroin, I guess. It's, yeah, white powdery stuff, and you cook it, and you inject it. That's heroin. That's heroin, right? I only know the Japanese term for it now. It's Kokusei.
Okay.
Everyone is always arrested. They arrest a lot of people for being users of Kokusei, and they say it's a result of the constant drug use from the 90s, and a lot of people were never able to just, you know, get through that because there aren't very good addiction rehabilitation centers in Japan. So.
See, Miko says that's heroin.
Okay. Thank you for the confirmation.
Thank you. All right. Well, I didn't know. So there's a heroin problem in Japan. There's also a cocaine problem.
Yeah, on the new, on the TV shows, they only, I've only ever really seen them get people for heroin. And I don't know if that is on purpose because y'all know Japanese TV shows are very manufactured. So they could be on purpose only showing heroin drug busts. They actually only show heroin and marijuana drug busts. Wow. I've only seen maybe in the like years I've been watching this TV program, I've only seen one cocaine bust. And I've been watching this program for like 5 years.
Okay.
So.
But so like a while ago, I think it was like a couple months ago, you told me that there was a cocaine problem in Japan. Remember that?
No.
Wow. I just made that up, I guess. I guess I made that up. But like, isn't a cocaine there?
Cocaine problem? I don't know.
Oh my
Not
God.
As far as I know.
Then who told me that? I don't just make this up. Someone told me that
you
there
got, you got the good info, I guess. I don't know, because I don't know nothing about cocaine in Japan.
I'm trying to remember who told. It doesn't really matter on the show. But yeah, I did hear that there was still like a cocaine problem, but it's just not shown. And like you said, it's not on the TV show.
But I wouldn't doubt that if someone said that to me. I'd be like,
and since I don't do drugs, I don't know.
That's like a rich people drug, and rich people ain't getting arrested.
I don't
in Japan.
Know where you're gonna find that. Yeah, well, they so like that's another thing. Like celebs who get caught, the one celebrity that got caught was high and was like calling the police because he was paranoid that someone was in his house.
Oh wow!
So then he got caught because of that.
Yo.
Another, I think the girl.
Supposed to call a friend.
Right. The girl that had the MDM.
Erika Sawajiri.
Yeah. Someone snitched on her, you think, right?
Yeah, because it's well known that there are snitches that, like, go in, they run in celeb circles, and they'll basically just snitch on celebs that are, they know are doing drugs and have done drugs.
That's crazy.
So, they think that someone saw her in the club buy the drugs, because she didn't get, she wasn't charged with use.
Right.
She was charged with possession.
Okay.
And she only had like two pills.
Okay.
And then I think she also might have had like a tab of LSD or something.
Yeah, yeah.
And she wasn't using these things because they test her urine, but they found it in her house.
Mm.
And I was like, how did they know to even go to this random woman's house to look for like two pills of
tiny ass pills.
Right. And they were like, my friend was like, yeah, they got like snitches in the celebrity world. And they would just snitch on people and be like, yeah, I saw so-and-so in the club doing this and that. And the police will go after you. I guess that's all the info they need to go after somebody.
Right.
I don't know, but
Ray said someone snitched on her. They don't do raids like that unless there's a complaint.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ray also just said, oh, nah, not coke, but meth. Okay, so meth what? Is...
Oh, is
meth,
the one that's...
Meth is an issue.
I believe that, because that's an amphetamine.
Oh,
it's a methamphetamine,
okay.
But it's the same type of drug, so...
What does this say? Oh, Ayana the 13th. Hey, same name. I know three dudes from Japanese rock bands that got busted for weed recently. Someone was snitching.
Y'all better watch out. Snitches out here.
That's why, like, people are like, don't be, nope, I don't talk about that shit. Nope.
Yeah. It's, especially for those celebrities.
Right, really same dangerous. Thing with the ex-Cartoon member, Takuchi.
Yeah, I think he got busted for possession.
He did.
I feel bad for it. Like, the people getting busted for, like, marijuana, I feel so bad for them. Because I'm like,
it's just marijuana!
And then, when these celebrities get busted, you would think it would just be a quick news story. It's like, so-and-so was busted for marijuana.
They dragged that shit.
Today in news. Worry about your government and the shady shit they're doing.
Shut the fuck up. It's just marijuana.
Yeah. No, instead, they go on, like, these long-ass, like, And then here's the history of drugs, and we have to fight against drugs. And it sounds like the propaganda we heard in the 90s about, you know, like, don't do drugs. Dare. And like, their stats are ripped straight from that. So they still call marijuana a gateway drug, even though it's already been proven that that is not the case. Wow. On Japanese news programs, they still call it a gateway drug. And they'll try to, like, explain to people what it's like being on marijuana. And the commenters will be like, oh, that sounds so scary. Really, oh, I would never do that. It's they're really stoking this fear of drugs on a populace that has absolutely no idea what it's about.
Right.
So then everyone, you know, Shota, he comes with these ideas. He's like, oh, marijuana makes you crazy. And I'm like, have you been watching Reefer Madness? Like, where are you getting this information? That is... What? Why do you think that? So,
that's terrible.
And that's what makes me think that they are not interested in changing drug laws anytime soon at all. Because they're still peddling this misinformation, and they're okay with that. But then you have to also remember they have alcohol. They have a big drinking industry.
They do.
And the drinking industry don't want people coming in on their money.
It would make sense.
Is if marijuana became popular, there are a lot of people that don't drink. If it became popular, I could see it overtaking the drinking industry.
Well, I would think that, like, if they can see how the United States is, like, their marijuana business industry is booming, maybe they can do the same thing, too. Like, it's not going to take away from alcohol. But
then they have to change things, man. And you know how Japan feels about changing things.
They don't like change.
They don't want to change nothing. They're not changing.
But it would be such a good boom in their economy.
They need it.
But then I remember, like, hearing from someone saying, like, oh, Japanese people don't need marijuana because you see how they are with alcohol. They'll just abuse it.
I think I might have said that.
It was you. See, I never remember who said it, but as long as I say
it. I mean, I'm just commenting on the people I've seen, like, asleep on concrete and, like, falling off their bicycles drunk. Like, they I mean, but that's also just some people. Like, we have the same problem in the U.S. of some people abusing any kind of drug, legal or otherwise. Right. So there's always going to be abusers out there regardless. But I feel bad for Japanese people that get punished so harshly for such minor offenses.
Especially when, like, especially the girl with the cookie, that was, I think, 110 milligrams.
Mm-hmm. What was that?
I don't really know so much, like, the size, like, off the bat, but I had bought a bag of edibles in L.A., right. So no one thinks I did it in Japan, in L.A., and it was, like, just 10 gummies that all had 10 milligrams, and when I took one, it was too much for me, because I'm not, like,
She had one cookie with 100 milligrams?
I don't think it was 100 milligrams. I don't know how many cookies there were. I think there was, like, three.
Right, maybe, so maybe 100 between the three.
Yeah, maybe. Something like that.
Okay.
So, you don't eat the whole cookie when you have edible like that. You never eat... Like every time I talk to somebody...
I got a cookie, I'm eating that whole
cookie. I'm just saying, every time I talk to somebody about edibles, and if they're a cookie or a brownie, they say, don't eat the whole thing right away. Yeah. With gummies, like, they're usually really small, and they usually have, like, 10 milligrams. Mm. So, that's fine. But, like, anything bigger is, like, eat a little bit. Because 10 is a lot already in your system. But anyway, the fact is, she only had 110, and that's not a lot.
It's not enough to be...
It's not a lot to, like, arrest someone and say, like, oh, this is importing, and, like, you're trying to sell. Like, you're not. You're just trying to do it for personal use. But anyway, that's what it is in Japan. So don't do drugs in Japan. What is this... Oh, okay. You know someone who sells edibles in Cali? Well, like, when I went to Cali, there was a whole store that looked like the Apple store. Basically, like, everybody was, like, all the employees were dressed in, like, red shirts. They had, like, the tables, and it was, like, really clean. And they were just telling information about all the different strains. They had, like, little canisters, like, with glass. You can see the buds, and you can smell it. Mm-hmm. And then you have the edible side. So it's like, yeah, California, they have their... They're dispensaries. It's fine, but not in Japan. They're not going to do it. But they have CBD. CBD oil is okay.
CBD oil is legal in Japan.
Yes. So I could bring, like, maybe infused, something infused.
I brought my CBD stuff from Hawaii. I bought some tea.
Oh.
But, I mean, they're not going to...
Did you read about why CBD is legal?
Because it doesn't have any of the hallucinogenic effects of... It doesn't have THC in it. That's why.
And from what I read a while ago is that the prime minister's wife...
Oh, yeah. She needed it for some, like...
Medical?
Something medical.
Something medical. So then she kind of, like, did a little push saying, like, it's okay. Mm-hmm. And then that's when more CBD stuff came...
Yeah, there's a lot of places in Hawaii that sell it now.
Oh.
With Japanese on it.
Oh.
Yeah. They're like, hey, you can take this back to Japan. It's not weed. you won't get high when you use it.
Right. It just relaxes you a little bit.
Yeah.
There's like creams and stuff maybe with CBD.
I wonder if there is a boom in Hawaii for like Japanese tourists who just wanna use CBD. I don't know. I haven't heard any news like that.
No, recently, I haven't.
But that would be funny if there was.
Hmm. There would be. Is there anything else? Well, not so much. This is when we were talking about meds before, but mm-hmm. just make sure, like, if you are coming to Japan from whatever country and you need medicine,
right?
You need to research what medicine is legal and what's not.
Yes.
Like what you said before was amphetamines.
Yes.
So Adderall has,
and it's an amphetamine,
right?
Methamphetamines.
Yeah.
Methamphetamines.
So just make sure that you don't have medicine that has that in there.
Yes, I think there are some allergy meds that have a small amount. Whatever, because there is an allergy med you can make meth from. I forget which one it was. I think it's Claritin or something.
Oh, yeah.
But, so you can't, I think you might not be able to bring that into Japan. They might just take it from you. And I've had them take allergy meds from my bag, but I didn't get in trouble for it. They just took, like, I had two bottles. Okay. They just took one. I guess you could only bring... And that wasn't Claritin either, so it was just regular allergy meds.
But. So to kind of go back to the girl with the Adderall, you said that she didn't have it in her medicine.
It was in a Tylenol bottle,
but it wasn't Tylenol.
Yes, so that's why they were like that gave them probable cause maybe for smuggling.
Yeah, I feel like if she had the actual prescription bottle,
right, with her name and everything on it,
she would have been fine. That sucks.
Keep your stuff in.
Keep your stuff labeled,
but also properly. Maybe don't bring it.
Yeah, don't bring it.
It might be easier that way, which sucks. And I don't know how they. I don't even know if they treat ADHD or ADD in Japan.
Because, I had a child that had severe ADHD. Like I'm not a doctor, but to me that kid mm-hmm. had issues. Like it was just all over bouncing all over.
Right, right.
But they're actually good with English. They just was too much. So I was like. They send them to English school to treat them.
I had a similar student like that because he was a twin and his sister was really quiet and she liked studying English, but the brother would just like run around the room and like terrorize people, and I was like, mm-mm. Yo, come get your son, he's ruining my class.
Yeah, it's just too much.
But I don't think there's any medical treatments for it here as far as I know.
Yeah, I don't know what they do. It's sad. Miko said Advil is allowed. Yes, it is.
Yes. And Advil, Tylenol.
Yeah. Ibuprofen.
Ibuprofen's okay. What's the other? Anthem is what's in Advil.
What is that?
I can't remember how to say it. It's a acetaminophen, acetaminophen,
antihistamine?
No. But it's what makes, like, it's the difference. I want to say it's the difference between, like, Tylenol and Advil or something. Okay. It's, like, one extra thing in it.
Okay.
Where's my mom to help me with the medical words?
It's fine. So there's a difference.
Acetaminophen.
That doesn't help it. I don't know what you're saying still.
Y'all know it. Y'all seen it on the pill bottle. It's a long A-C-E to acetaminophen.
Yeah. Just look at the bottle. If you have it. Mickey Bell said...
That's the one. Acetaminophen.
You still don't know how to say it.
Acetaminophen?
I don't know. Is that how you say it?
See? I'm sorry. I think it's acetaminophen. Acetaminophen? But
That's the word?
That's the word. That is not in Japanese painkillers, which is why I'd be like, ugh. Not over-the-counter ones. I think you have to get prescription ones to have that in it.
I mentioned the 420 store a little ways above the chat. Can you...
What? Uh-oh. 420 store? What? There's a 420 store? Wait a minute.
What? So, Miko said that one shop that's called 420 in Amemura that sells drug paraphernalia, bubblers, bongs, etc., but can get away with it because there's no actual drugs in the store, apparently. Japanese... Japanese owned, but I bet if it was foreigner owned, it would have been raided.
Yep.
Yes.
You know, they would have been in there like swimwear.
I think I've been in there.
Actually, there's a couple head shops that I've been to in Osaka, and one of them used to sell these. There's this drug in Japan. I forget what it's called now. They call it hapa. I think they called it just hapa, which is like leaves. So you'd be like, oh shit, this sounds like marijuana. But it wasn't marijuana. It was some kind of synthetic herb is what it was called. It's like a synthetic herb. Mm. And it was legal because it didn't exist anywhere.
Okay.
So all these head shops were selling it, and they were selling it as like an incense. So it said on the package that you should not smoke it. But people were smoking it anyway, and like...
What happened to them?
They would be going crazy because it's like a mixture of synthetic drugs that nobody knows what it is. So people would smoke it and start driving and get into like crazy accidents. I want to say this was like 2 or 3 years ago.
Spice?
Yeah, it was the spice. It was a spice.
That is terrible. And they had,
and there's, and I was just watching a TV show about it, and they like, it's over 2,000 types of it because it's all synthetic. Okay. And it was all coming over from China. It was just a bunch of synthetic drugs coming from China. And they just had to ban it.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah. It was like 2 or 3 years ago, because I remember seeing it in the shop, and I was like, the freak is this little foil packet? It had the marijuana leaf on it, so I was like,
why would you do that to people? That is confusion.
Yeah. Yeah, there was that drug, and then there was another kind of, it's like a speed drug that was a drink that was being imported from China for a while, but they banned that too.
Oh, God.
There's a lot of, like, new synthetic drugs that keep coming through that people will try here because they'll be illegal. They will be legal for, like, a short span before the government finds it. And they're looking for a good time. But they're usually, like, weird synthetic things that you probably shouldn't be.
I don't want to try any synthetic stuff. What is that? K2? K2 is a thing?
Yeah. What?
Is that a synthetic drug? Is that what he's saying?
K2. I don't know.
I don't know what that
means. Is that maybe
that's... Han, what do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
Exfoliate. Not exfoliate.
recently, I also read that shrooms were legal. And yeah. They used just to be. They were just banned in 2000.
Not just. 2002 was a while ago.
To me, that is just...
That's 20 years
that
ago.
That is just to me because, like... You know, marijuana was illegal, started illegal in America, like 1940s, right? Mm. Or 30s or something. So that's me, to me, that's a long time ago. So if you're in the 2000s just being banned, I'm like, wow. For Japan, especially for Japan, that is recent.
They banned it before the what's it called? World Cup, the 2002 World Cup, which was my first time coming to Japan. I was in Japan during that World Cup, but they had already banned shrooms. So, and I was also like a... freshman in high school, so I was probably
you weren't
not
thinking
do,
about
I wasn't gonna be doing no shrooms
but
anyway.
Like people on Twitter, because I had mentioned that, like, oh, you know, this was banned at this time, someone was like, yeah, I was there for that. They had like little like vending machines. They had it in vending machines. They had shrooms in vending machines.
they will put anything in a vending machine, anything. Won't they?
Well, I was like,
I guess
wow.
That won't be coming back, huh?
I guess not. So that, to me, my mind is like, oh, if the Olympics is coming and people want to do marijuana, they're going to probably keep marijuana banned because
true.
Foreigners.
True.
So there's that.
And they're probably only going to start really cracking down even more than they already have been. So don't be surprised if an officer walks up to you looking funny because... I got carded for the first time.
Oh wow!
By the police.
So
like,
you
2 weeks ago.
58 episodes in, or 59, whatever. I don't remember. This whole time, Alyse has not been carded.
I've never been stopped and asked for my gaijin card by the police, and it happened one Saturday morning at 12 p.m. in broad daylight while I was waiting for my friend to open his tattoo shop. And I was just standing outside on my phone, and he was like, oh, excuse me, can I see your gaijin card? And I was
like, did he say it in English?
Yeah, he started in English.
That's kind of cute.
And then my friend came out and was like, what the fuck, man? And I was like, nah, it's cool. Here's my card. And he was like, how do you say your last name, which is a Japanese last name? And I was like, Sugahara. And he was like, oh, arigatou.
Hilarious.
And then he went on his way.
And that's it. I guess you look suspicious.
I'm so sus. Just standing out at 12 p.m. on a Saturday afternoon.
12 p.m.
Broad daylight, under the sun. Just chilling.
So red hair, red afro.
I have my leather coat on. I think that's what kicked.
Oh, that's it. You're a pusher. That's it.
So...
Well, that's it. That's all we have the rest of our episode. We enjoyed this conversation with y'all and who joined in the lives. Probably a total of maybe 10 people.
Hey, that's cool, though. Having a live conversation.
It's fine. Like
I live fact checkers. Yeah. Thank you, fact checkers.
Thank you, Ray, Nico, Han, Ayana. I don't remember everybody else's name. Clinton. And everybody else who just came in and then came out, that's fine too.
Yeah, we'll have a recording of this up later this week, so you can re-listen.
If you want to re-listen, or not. But share. And yeah, I'll also post the links in the show notes.
Of the articles, the documentaries.
Yes. Oh, and we helped Mickey get ready for work.
Get ready for work.
So we'll try this again, and we'll try to do better with preparation and getting maybe better cameras to do.
Because it's hard to find what's going to work with the live function
of
the apps.
That's true.
You can't use it on your big camera.
No. But it looked like we had more people on our Facebook, so we're going to try to do more Facebook Lives. I don't know. We could still do both Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah.
Not everybody uses Facebook. A lot of people in the States don't use Facebook anymore. I found that. True. That's a thing.
Me too.
Yeah. Whoops. Whoopsie daisy. All right, then. Well, it's getting late. It's 8:30 around here in this part.
It's my bedtime.
Please tell people about our show, and when we have this up and recorded, please share the episode.
Yes.
Like and subscribe. Comment.
Find us arguing with people on Twitter.
Yes, we are active on, I know I'm active on Twitter. Please talk to us on Twitter. Our main page isn't really that active, but our personal pages are more active.
If they're messy. Oh, yes. Come through.
I don't know if it's messy. Mine's not messy.
It's not messy in a bad way. Messy in a good way. It's a good mess. Okay. Mine is messy, as in it's just random stuff.
Yeah,
it's not random stuff.
Whatever. Anyway, thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time. Bye. I'm gonna head out. I like that.